Our base case is 3%, 100 points, but I think it could be as much as 5 to 10%.
5 to 10% on the S&P 500?
Yes.
And what brings us there?
Well, I think central to this is we have to have a turn in cyclical momentum. So the PMIs have to be bottoming now. I think there's some clues because, you know, China's done pretty well. Germany's DAX is actually a really cyclical index that's turning. And the yield curve's been telling us this. But without, I mean, that's really critical. And then the second is the Fed can't make a policy error.
We just had disappointing PMIs, though, in the latest readings on manufacturing and services as well. So are you already looking for a turn in that? That was the bottom?
Yeah. So at the start of this year, we were advising our clients that the PMIs would likely fall to as low as 48 by September. So but at the beginning of this year, because of the downturn in oil and the Fed tightening from last year, plus the signal from the long-term yield curve told us we'd be seeing a tanking of the PMIs, that same yield curve is telling us they should be bottoming now. So
you said a Fed policy error. What would a policy error be? Would it be standing pat at the next meeting? Would it be not cutting in December? What would a policy error look like?
I think the policy error last year was the Fed wasn't paying enough attention to market signal, and they were following contemporaneous economic data. To us, a policy error is ignoring the fact that the yield curve in the U.S. is messed up. You know, the term structure is broken. There's no, as Bill Gross said earlier this week, there's no incentive for long-term investment to take place when the curve is as flat as it is. So the Fed, I think, needs to do at least 25 basis points to kind of bring some normalization to the curve.
That's assuming, though, that the Fed has control over short-term rates.
They have a lot of control over the front end. It's really been the long end that's been less predictable, and good news is the long end has been moving up, but I think we need to bring the front end down.
Is that why you like the home builders?
Yes, I think the home builders are really the deepest cyclical bet you can make. You know, so they don't have any reason to rally if the economy is about to turn down, and they've done really well this year. But a piece that we did last year is pointing out that the 6 months, like if you buy the home builders on October 20th of every year, 17 of the last 20 years and nine out of the last 10, you beat the market.
Why October 20th?
It's a weird.
It's the 22nd. We're 2 days late.
Yeah, it's a strange mathematical coincidence. In fact, it was a J.P. Morgan summer intern that first pointed this out to me like 7 years ago.
Wow.
Yeah, it was one of his summer projects.
So in terms of this trade, does it matter that the home builders have already been up a lot going into this period?
It's a good question because, yeah, year to date, they've been essentially monsters, right? Up over almost 50% for some. But that's the same thing that happened in 2003, 2000, and 2012. So it's happened three times where they're up close to 50% year to date. Even in that next 6 months, they built on those gains, 30 to 50% more. So I think it's actually a sign that it might do even better.
You say a 3% move in the S&P between now and year end, base case, right?
Yes.
What happens in 2020? Does that get stocks to a price where they are vulnerable, say, to a 10% or greater correction in 2020?
You know, our thinking is markets have gone nowhere for 20 months. So we've had flat markets hovering near all-time highs. It's only happened three times since World War II. Three times it was resolved with a massive upside breakout in stocks. So I think if the S&P hits that 3,100, it's going to be the fourth instance. I think it tells us S&P 4,500 by 2021. So I think 2 years.
What does the intern think?
Huh?
I said, what does the intern think?
I got to go. I'm going to have to find him on Bloomberg. Yeah. But it's 2 years of 20% gains that might follow.
Oh, wow. All right.